David Strother. Coach, before we get into it, man, thanks for taking time out of your day.
Yeah, thanks for having me. It's exciting to finally be back in the office and speaking with you about things we got coming up for the upcoming season.
Well, let's just talk about it first, and this is the first thing I talked about with Sully as well. You had 8 months to prepare for the season, and you know, right now you're wrapping up 7-on-7. So just talk about the dynamic that has been this year, the complete change. You've got more time to practice, but eventually the players, I coined AI earlier, you know, you got to be tired of practice.
Yeah. Yeah, I think you're exactly right. We actually had a discussion last night about this. It's going to get to a point where we just want to play other people now. Mm-hmm. And so 8 months of being drawn out and taking a little bit or a lot longer time than what it normally does, we're trying to take 8 months to do what we normally do in 3 or 4 weeks. Yeah. And so finding that rhythm and trying to make sure that there's a continuous growth through that whole entire 8 month period, it's been challenging, not only for the players, it's been challenging for myself. Making sure that we're always continuing to grow and always continue to improve without looking towards competition. So now that we're finally getting into that upcoming season, there's excitement on both ends as a coach, and I know the players are certainly excited, and we're just looking forward to finally getting able to kick off.
Absolutely. Well, last year, historic. Mm-hmm. Just best season ever in the program's history. How are you going to build off that success with the girls returning, new faces coming in as well, to work to continue to build on that success?
Well, great thing about JUCO is you're always restarting a program. Yeah. Almost. You know, you have half of your team that always leaves and half of your team that returns. One thing I've been very prideful about my time here at Itawamba, and also not just what I've been able to do as a coach, but the players have come in, we've always been able to grow on the previous year's success. And so we're going to continue to do that. We're not necessarily dictating it off of wins and losses. We never do. Mm-hmm. We always just judge it off of how much we're performing, how much we're improving from when we started to when we finish. And now that we've had 8 extra months, hopefully there's a lot more improvement that's going to take place. But you can put accolades towards wins and losses, and we certainly had a record-breaking season last year. But we're looking to just continue to grow the program in a positive state, not just on what we do on the field, but also off the field. And I feel like this class has just been doing a phenomenal job over that for the past 8 months.
And the good thing is, and I say the good thing, but it's a unique thing, you're actually Division II now, mm-hmm. which technically we've kind of been Division II competing in Division I.
That's right.
But talk about the unique aspect of going in now, being that Division II program where the playing field's a little bit more even now.
Yeah, no, I think you're exactly right, and that's something that I've been excited about. Knowing that as a Division I competitor, you were always going up against other schools that were able to offer full tuition along with room and board with a Division II status, which is what we've always been through our scholarship packages, is just offering the full tuition without room and board. So anytime that we got to the next level, once you got into the region tournament, or once you got to the national tournament, the playing field wasn't even.
Right.
And so it's nothing against our opponents. You know, they're just in a different bracket. Our competitive level is going to stay the same. I think it's going to even raise our competition, both in our conference, but also at the national level, because once we get to that national tournament, everyone's on an even playing field playing at the same Division II level. And so that's exciting because we've been able to show a lot more respect for the Mississippi soccer product. Now there's an automatic bid for whoever wins the conference this upcoming season, makes an automatic bid into the national tournament, which will be a first-time occurrence for anyone in the state of Mississippi.
And it's like Sully said, why not be the first?
That's right. That's right.
So, and we're talking with Coach David Strother, ICC Women's Soccer Coach. And Coach, before we talk about this upcoming season, some of the returning players, let's just look back at last year. Mm-hmm. I know you don't like to look back because you look back, you're not moving forward,
That's right.
A special year like that doesn't come around all the time. Just sort of reflect on last year's successes and just the season as a whole.
Yeah, well, it was definitely successful, most successful we've had in the history of the program here at Itawamba. But for me, it was just about the journey. You know, starting out in the process of August, and I think we had 16 freshmen with that season last year. And so just seeing the growth that took place from them, because we didn't start out great. I think we were maybe 1-3 as we were getting into the first leg of our division matches. So it wasn't a great start on our behalf. I thought we certainly could have been a lot better, but to see the buy-in, it just took a little bit longer, but to see the buy-in take place on a gradual game-by-game, practice-by-practice status, it was amazing. It was one of those seasons that you never want to see end.
Yeah.
You know, we got into a run where I think we had 16 games in a row that we won, and it got to a point where I was forgetting what the number was, and my players were reminding me. But I've never been the type of coach who really builds on records. I couldn't tell you what my overall record is here at Itawamba. I just try to focus on the upcoming game and then the next game after after that. But it was neat to see my players buy into that. And there were even times where it got close to maybe a tie, and it was looking like maybe this game wasn't going to go our way.
Yeah.
And you could see the buy-in from the players, like, no, coach, we want this streak to continue.
Nice.
And so that was just something that was pretty amazing to see. It was leadership from our sophomores that then trickled into our freshmen, who are now sophomores for us, and they've been leading this program for the past eight months. And so I'm excited to see now that as we're moving forward into this season, how much buy-in our current freshman class can buy into what the sophomore leadership class has.
All right, so let's talk about those sophomores this season. Who are you going to lean on? Who's taking over those leadership roles for the team?
Leaning on all of them. I think we have to. You know, I'm certainly going to list a few players that I think are going to stand out for us this upcoming season, some that has some great accolades from last season. But in reality, the way we try to operate our team, we're 24 on roster, and we expect all 24 to play within the guidelines of a 90-minute game. I think that's one thing that separates us from some of our opponents in the conference, is we're not just, you know, 10 or 11 strong. I feel like we're 24 strong.
Yeah.
So we want our players to play. So we're going to rely on our sophomore leadership. I think at any time I could have 11 sophomores start in a match. I could also have 11 freshmen start in a match, and that's something that just goes towards the growth and just the hard work of our full class. But key players returning, I think we start with the back line and build off of our goalkeeper, Anna West Driscoll.
Yes.
I thought she had one of the strongest seasons, not just for our team last year, but in the entire conference run in the history of the conference. I think there were four different times that she was goalkeeper of the week. She was also nominated for goalkeeper of the week for the NJCAA. Mm-hmm. She won that award at least once, I believe. It may have been twice.
Yeah.
She finished with All-State accolades, and she's going to be leading the back line again for us this year. It was unique for her last year, where right at the beginning of the preseason, our returning goalkeeper unexpectedly wasn't able to come back. So it was just her, and she started every match for us and did a phenomenal job. Played 90 minutes every single game, unless there was overtime, and then there was one game, I think, against Northwest where she got a yellow card, had to go out for about a minute and a half, and then she came back in. But except for that, she was our starting goalkeeper, and she'll continue that path and lead our freshman goalkeeper, A.K. Trost, from the Lafayette area, Oxford area. She'll lead her and help balance out that time. A.K.'s a great goalkeeper, too,
nice.
And so we're going to try to balance out that time for them. Other sophomores, Emily Hayward is a returner for us. She's a leading goal scorer from last season. She's already a D1 signee, a commit, going to attend University of North Alabama this upcoming fall. But she decided to stay for an extra semester with us, which we're very fortunate for. She has the opportunity to now graduate with honors, and also that'll help her with some different packages and things she can get through scholarships at North Alabama. But we expect big things from her. Again, she led us in goal scoring as a freshman. We expect her to do some really good things for us out on the wing on the left side again this season. Another key player is Ashley Stevens. She was third in goals, so it's pretty nice whenever two out of your top three goal scorers from the best season in program history are returning. And so Ashley Stevens is a sophomore from Amory. She was third in goals for us last year. She was an All-State selection as well. And we just, you know, based on what she's been doing this past fall and the spring, man, she's just grown so much more. She's been very dynamic always going forward, but now to see her more in possession and being comfortable on the ball, she's really grown with that. And then in our midfield, Lexi Loden, she's a returner for us as well, and she started every match for us in the attacking mid role. We expect her to continue that for this upcoming season. And then on our back line, we have so many returners with Josie Kate Reeves, Lucy Dexter, Morgan Gaylor, Alexis Hall. They just showed a lot of leadership in our defending and as freshmen, and now getting into this sophomore year, we're expecting big things from them.
And to have that much talent returning on top of a really good recruiting class in your mm-hmm. freshman class, it's a tough problem to have as a coach when it comes to making that starting lineup.
That's right.
But at the same time, you sleep a little bit easier knowing you ain't got you've got a lot of options there.
That's right.
So talk about those freshmen that are coming in this year.
Yeah. So key freshmen for us. We have 12 on roster this year. So coming in as freshmen, I think one of the key players that's coming in straight away is going to be actually a transfer. She's a reverse transfer from Mississippi College. So she played at Mississippi College as a freshman. She transferred down to us this past fall. Her name's Sydney Hughes. She's a Tupelo High School graduate. We recruited her out of high school. She did great for her high school team and just ended up getting a great opportunity to go to Mississippi College and actually started for them down there. So we think she can be pretty dynamic in our league, super fast, really good on the ball, looking to score goals, and we want that in her role. She'll be a forward with us, so we expect that in her role. Another key player is in the midfield, and her name is Kirsten McGregor. She's an international student for us. She comes from Harrogate Town, which is a club team in England. It's second division women's club team out of England. Prior to COVID, very competitive. I think they were second or third in their league, and nice. Just came highly rated as a midfield player. And we used an agency to work with her to create an opportunity for her to come here. So those are two key players that I know straight away that are going to do some great things for us. But we've got, you know, a lot of depth, like what you mentioned. Yeah. I've already mentioned AK in the goalkeeping position. We've got Morgan Mitchell, who's leading goal scorer from Amory High School after Ashley Stevens left. Yeah. I think she finished with maybe around 35 or 40 goals her senior year, and so she'll come in and be a wing player for us. Gracie Gustafson, Heidi Clark, these are players from Grenada that led Grenada High School to one of the best records in the program's history. Sarah Bickert, who's a center midfielder that's going to come in from Corinth High School, and then Maria Jones, she's an outside back for us. These are all players I could go through the whole list. I know I'm missing some.
It's one of those unfortunate, you got so many good players and you're going to sit back and be like, I forgot, you know, this one. But that's a good problem to have.
Yeah, and we don't really, at least the way I try to coach them, I try to make them mindful about, I don't expect our players to be 90-minute players. And So the way that we train, the way that we work, is high intensity and high activity for 10, 15-minute intervals. Sometimes we go a little bit longer than that. But we did a scrimmage match, I think it was last Friday morning, and weather was cold. It was mid-50s, and it was a little chilly, and we kicked off at 8:30. And once the girls got their feet under them and started playing, they were absolutely flying. And nice. I even told them after the game, I said, you know, this is in comparison of, like, you could be the two top teams in the conference, and you're all in the same team, playing hard. And that's no distraction to our opponents. We have an extremely tough conference, and there's extremely great talent within this conference. But to be able to scrimmage a match and let it be full-blown for 90 minutes, almost like it's a key division match, that's a big thing in the way that I try to recruit and develop this team. So to have players that buy into that, you know, as competitors, they want to come in and play 90 minutes, and they don't necessarily always care about the score.
Right.
But we have competitors on our team that realize, you know, they can't go as hard as they'd want to for 90 minutes. Mm-hmm. They're willing to do that work for 20 minutes, 30 minutes at a time, and then rotate and let somebody else come in and do it. And then we don't dip. Our talent level, from what I've been seeing, should be able to stay the same. So that's pretty exciting.
Nice. And we're talking with Coach David Strother, the women's soccer coach here at ICC. Kind of led me into my next question. Competition across the league this year.
Mm-hmm.
Who is going to be some of the teams that we need to keep an eye on? Of course, the MACCC is always tough.
That's right.
I mean, in every sport. But who are going to be some of the standard bearers, other than ICC, that we need to keep an eye out this season?
Well, I think our key opponents in the North Division, you know, past couple seasons, it's always been us and Holmes Community College, kind of ranked one or two, or one or three, or somewhere within that. So I think Holmes, definitely in the North Division, is someone that we're always mindful about. But like you said, I mean, the conference is just, it's extremely competitive. And even with us being separated, North Division, South Division, our opponents in the North, Hines has gotten extremely stronger. East Central has gotten extremely stronger. Northwest went through a coaching change from the fall, but we scrimmaged them in the fall, and they were a very good team in the fall. They're only going to be even stronger now that they've had the same amount of time that we have. And so, you know, for us, it's on any given day, we just have to make sure we're doing the best that we possibly can. The North, we will always be prepared. That's my job as a coach, is to do my best to prepare them. In the South, I think Jones is going to be quite competitive. They had a really good recruiting class. Had an off year last year in comparison to what Coach Dolores has been able to do. I know she wasn't pleased with that, so she went out and had a great recruiting class. I knew a lot of the players that she was recruiting because we had earmarked those players as well. And so I know that they're going to be very strong. Pearl River will return a lot of key players. They're going to be strong too. And then Meridian's had a good recruiting class, and Gulf Coast has had a recruiting class. Southwest is in a little bit of a rebuilding stage with a new coach. Colin is restarting a program from scratch, but even those teams, I know what they've been able to bring in with some of their international players, and at any given day, we have to show up, and we've realized that in the past. So I think that goes down to also sophomore leadership, making sure that these sophomores make sure the freshmen understand how to buy in, how to prepare, how to know that it's nothing guaranteed.
Right.
In high school, you may have one or two of those games where it's senior night or homecoming night, and your coach is fortunate enough to maybe book someone that's not quite up to your level. We don't have that in our league. And now that we're moving to this Division II status, I think the preseason rankings come out in a week or two. I would expect a few of us Mississippi Division II programs to be ranked in the top 20, just because of how competitive we've been in the past, and that's exciting. We want to see as much recognition, not just for us at Itawamba, but we want to see recognition from across the league, because that helps our recruiting, that helps our players then get identified for the next level, and it just helps put more of a national stamp on the whole entire league for us.
Well, David, anything else you want to talk about before we wrap things up?
You know, I would like to talk a little bit about COVID and how much that we're appreciative from the administrative staff and how resilient we've been through this process. It seems like it's almost been a full year and maybe even a little bit longer, and now it does seem like we've kind of taken that turn. And so just to thank the administration for seeing the bigger vision and looking at things from a safe standpoint, from a protocol standpoint that could still be productive for our students. I've talked with other coaches in other leagues, and I've talked with other coaches from other levels, and some of their students haven't even been on campus since freshmen, you know, coming in for the first time, or some of them haven't been able to train on campus, some of them haven't even been able to have a season. So I know that it wasn't exactly the right fit for us, and I know it wasn't exactly what we wanted, but to have the opportunity to now be into a season, and we can see, you know, we're at the end line, we're finally there, you know, I thank the administration, the leadership from across the state, the vision of what they were trying to do that's best suited for our students and our athletes. I can't say thank you enough. I went through COVID myself and navigated through that. We had it a little bit come through with the team and just the way that our leadership, especially Dr. Brad Boggs, how he was so resilient and being adamant about being on the front side of stuff and not being overreactive, but being very professional about it. I can't thank them enough. Dr. Allen, Tyler Camp, all of the ones that were in the decision-making process, just extremely appreciative.
100% back you on that, because it has been an adventure, to say the least, but we've had great leadership along the way.
So,
David, looking forward to the start of the season. We're hoping to get started Thursday, Mother Nature, this springtime.
If it's not COVID, can we have something else just giving distractions?
So. But as soon as you guys get started, we're going to look forward to another great season, and best of luck this year.
Thank you. Really appreciate it. Roll Tribe.
Might be a little while before I get to the bank.
That's an incomplete pass. Let's give it a Renaissance replay. Renaissance Mobile Check Deposit. Make the right call and open an account with Renaissance today.